Hello, it's 5:51 in the morning. It's a Wednesday morning, and I will talk to you about my grandfather's mistake. He told me how he became the boss man. He said that he worked in the muelle, which is the dock, where the ships would come in and the chiquita bananas would be loaded onto the ship. And for 3 days, a month, he was busy with the ship. I'm not sure how many ships came in a month, but for 3 days, each time a ship showed up, he would be busy. He said that he started 20 years ago, and well, at the moment, he started at some time, and for 20 years, people kept saying, "I'm leaving. This is boring. I don't like this job. I'm getting out of here." And they would leave. And he stayed there all those years. The captains used to say, "Oh, this is such a beautiful port. This is a paradise." And he used to look around and he would say, "All it is coconuts and that's it." But it was a paradise in comparison, in my eyes, because when you go to Miami Beach, there's no parking, there's too much traffic, the buildings are so tall they cover the ocean, so if you go swimming, then you're in the shade after a certain time of the day, after 12, I think. So it's better over there, and it's small, so you actually see the people and you see them again the next day and so on. It's in Honduras, in Tela, Honduras, it's small. So back to my grandpa, he said that the ship's captains would ask him to come to the United States. "We're going to Louisiana, we're going to Miami, we're going to New York." And he always stayed. Eventually, he said, somebody made him the boss of the dock because he knew everyone's job and everyone had left. And many of them had returned to say, "Please give me a job anywhere, anywhere," because they couldn't get a job. There was only one company back then where it was the United Fruit Company. Whether you worked on the railroad, on the plantation, or the refrigerator making ice, or on the dock. So my grandpa's mistake was, when he finally came to Chicago, my mom put him to wash dishes because he couldn't speak English, and it was an insult to him in the sense that men in Honduras don't wash dishes. And he would say, "Adios gracias, no vine antes." Thank God I didn't come sooner to the United States. All right. Then I remember asking him about the dishes, and he said that he didn't like it because his body was diabetic and his skin was very thin, and that the hot water would hurt his skin. Even though he had gloves, my mom got him some gloves. Another mistake that he had was, I know he knew about electricity because he had a car battery that would give us light at night. And there was no electricity in the boondocks where we lived, or I lived with him. But he didn't teach me about electricity. Didn't teach me about carpentry or plumbing. It was more like, "You're a kid, stay away from me." Not that he didn't love me, he did, but the day that the plumber came to put in well, it wasn't a pipe, but it, because it wasn't circular, but it was a plumbing it looked like a V. He put that in the back of the house so that the plumbing from the toilet water would, I think it was the toilet water, would run out. Maybe it was for the shower. If I had a son, I would have included him. Look, we're getting plumbing. A daughter, same thing. So when I was 16, I lived with my grandparents when I was approximately 2 years old to seven, or yes, I was seven years old. I returned when I was about 11, but at 16, I did was it 16? No, at 16, he already had sold the property. At 11 or so, I returned from Chicago to Honduras, and I saw the house. There were many problems with it. It was a house on stilts, so there were these columns holding the house. The columns were a little bit shorter than me, so maybe 4 feet, 5 feet tall. Probably 4 feet tall. Maybe 3, 6, 9. 9 of them holding up the house. There were 7 stairs to climb up to get to the porch. And once inside, the house was made out of wood, and I could see the dirt floor through the holes of the tongue and groove floor. He had hardwood floors, right? And they are like rulers, and one matches the other, and so on. But they already had holes. So his mistake was not learning carpentry so he could build up or fix up that house. Another mistake was not learning to be a bricklayer so he could build a house made out of bricks. Another mistake was relying on a company to pay him, because as soon as he got fired, his income stopped, and all that land, he never planted any crops. He did tell me that he didn't like selling tomatoes, that's the one job he couldn't do, that the tomatoes are up 5 cents, they're down 10 cents, or they're 10 cents a bunch, now they're 5 cents a bunch. That type of work he would not be able to do. I'm thinking, though, he could have hired someone to grow food for him. My grandpa had a brother that had a daughter, right? And she used to ride the... Well, first, my uncle had a coffee plantation. And every year, one of the trucks would get stopped on the road. And the money would... Or the crop would be stolen. So perhaps my grandpa didn't want to deal with that. Eventually, though, the daughter flew on a helicopter over the crops. And so she had a better management system. My grandpa would say she was really into the growing the coffee. Not like her uncle, her father rather, he was just into spending some time having fun with crops. coffee crop, like a hobby. She was doing a serious business. My grandpa said that she wanted to double the production or have the same amount of production in 5 years that her father had made in 30 years with new systems and so on, innovation. All right. Well, they had a helicopter, so. All right, so my grandpa's mistakes were not teaching me how to. Well, my father left me, so my grandpa didn't teach me how to work as a laborer. He was the man that used to pay the people, like the payroll clerk, among other things. See you in the next video. God bless you.